a collaborative project by the UK College of Design School of Interiors, GBBN Architects, and UK Healthcare, examined just how well the emergency department design is meeting the needs of patients, visitors, and staff.
We do the best job we can solving the owner's puzzle, if you will, the design process. But we don't often go away with an understanding of how the building actually works, how the design works.
We always are striving to make design better for our users, and that's staff, visitors, patients. GBBN, having such a strong focus in healthcare design, was very, very interested in knowing, as a result of the work that they did at UK, what was working well, what may need to be rethought, not just for this space, but also for future design projects.
Having the opportunity to go in and look at the emergency department to understand how well the design is working really has an impact on what will happen on future floors of the UK hospital.
We typically see an average of about 200 patients a day. That includes adults and children. We've had as many as 110 patients at one time. The visitors that go with them, the staff, you start ending up in the hundreds of people at one time in that space. So 40,000 square feet sounds like a lot, but not when you think about 300 and 400 people at one time. It's not that much.
So we were in the emergency department for over 200 hours for the first phase. We worked in five teams of two, undergraduate and graduate researchers were involved in this process and asking them week by week to carry out different research studies.
This post-occupancy evaluation used observation, surveys, and focus groups to collect data and revealed many positives of the emergency department. The first was quality staff.
Something that UK should be really proud of is the quality of their staff, and patients and visitors overwhelmingly said they were the number one thing that they thought was best about the environment in the emergency department.
Another plus were pods, patient rooms clustered around a central nurse's station, so the staff didn't have to travel to check on their patients or to gather medications and supplies. The most critically injured patients get rapid care, thanks to a direct elevator from the helicopter pad to the trauma and imaging unit in the center of the emergency department. The dedicated pediatric center was a favorite of visitors and staff.
That's probably one of the best things that we did, was to have the McKenna David Pediatric Emergency Center. In the old emergency department, we had a little small area that we called kids care, where we saw children, but we had very few beds. So that was really a big plus for us to be able to have that space, to have 12 dedicated beds.
In the waiting room, GBBN used a lot of positive distractions. So there was interactive wall, there was a computer stations, there were some TVs, there were just things to help children who were probably not feeling well or experiencing some kind of trauma to feel comfortable.
The study also revealed a few areas that could use improvement.
There's a corridor that sits behind the registration desk. We found through our discussions with the staff members that this area was actually designed a little bit too small and that it really doesn't allow for an effective flow through that environment.
One of the problems that the staff that work there express is when the patients are sent back to either the adult area or the peds area, they really can't see the doors that they go through, and so they're not sure whether these people are going in the right direction.
Also, in the triage area, there are patient rooms that have dual entry. However, there's not a corridor that connects from this entry point of the emergency department to the patient service area.
I knew early on in the construction process that there was an issue that was created during the design of eliminating some circulation paths to cram in more treatment space.
We're finding that people are actually having to cut through these rooms.
Intake and triage were the focus of a one-day charrette, a design workshop held at GBBN, where the designers used the data to rethink the spaces.
What we found is that having the security situated right next to the entrance would give them sight lines to the doors leading back to the emergency department, but then also providing an opportunity to greet patients or families when they're walking in. One scenario also took triage and broke it up into two different areas with a central space moving from the entry point to the waiting area of the emergency department. From the design charrette, we documented all of these outcomes, so we have all of that on paper now.
The fact that they were able to publish their study is very beneficial for all of us. And anytime someone wants to look at something you're doing, it's gonna help you, because there's gonna be things that you don't know, and then there's gonna be things that you knew, but you needed the data to prove.
I've done over 40 emergency departments in my career. We are working on 4 other EDs right now, and some of the things that we're talking about, we're saying, well, you know, down at UK we did this POE, and this is what we learned here, and people, you know, they perk up and say, well, really, tell me more about it. So it, you know, has immediate use.
So this is not only a really great opportunity for the key collaborators on the project, but also for our students here at UK.
I really liked the immersive quality of the post-occupancy. The biggest thing I feel like I learned was how to do behavioral mapping. I think it's something that I can offer professional offices in the future, that I do know how a post-occupancy evaluation works, and I know how to evaluate successes and failures in a space. It was good to be in that space, to see how it functioned, to see how those different user groups needed to use the space and how the design was functioning.
It's not about bricks and mortar, it's about the environment. To realize that the noise level was low, to realize that there was privacy offered by the way we arranged space, all these things come together, and that's why I've always been interested in healthcare architecture. But to be able to give back and be a part of that patient or that family's caregiving years after the building is turned over to the owner is very rewarding.